know what that house is going to sell for.
Because nobody has the money to buy them.
Well, we have sales. We don't have as many as we'd like, and we're not having as many as we'd like in Indian County.
So all the rooms are all they double wide?
We got double wides, we got modulars, and we have stick builds.
They're not many modular homes in this county. They're not but a few modular homes in this county.
Actually, we have probably 6 or 8 modular homes. I can take you to one subdivision that's got 15 or 20 modulars in it. Because we had 3 sold out of that one subdivision.
How much do you carry there?
I'd have to get Renee to tell me. She drove me out there that day.
Well, let me ask you. I'm not a smart cookie, but let me ask you something.
Yes, sir.
Because I'm the one that'll probably have to go out and do this. You're sitting here feeding me all this mess about all the houses that sold last year. What are you going to do if I get twice as many to work on the market and didn't sell?
Does not matter. That's not the law.
Well, I'll tell you what.
The law plainly says we have to assess property in accordance with what has sold.
You assess it however you want.
Now, we assess it.
This thing right here is telling me. Let me ask you this. What you assessed it, right? What was your rate of going up?
Larger tracts of land went up about triple, about 300 or about 200% over.
Why?
Told you.
Because that's what they're selling for. If we had a tract of land that was on the books for 80, it pretty much brought 240. If we had a tract of land that was on the books for 50, it brought 150.
Are we looking at
it? It was pretty standard.
10%, 12%, 15%? What are we looking at? What did you rate this at over?
Because what we do is quite simple. I take the sales, I sit down with those sales, I've got that tax card. I say this piece of property sold for $50,000. It was on the tax books for $20,000. It went up 150% or 250%.
Let me try that question one more time because I think I might have lost you.
Okay.
What percentage rate did you raise people's property?
Different properties went up different percentages.
Oh, so what you're trying to say is, now let me get this straight, that there's a different standard for different people.
No, there's a different standard for different neighborhoods.
Then what is it?
For different neighborhoods.
That's right.
Yeah. What neighborhoods?
And all types or styles of houses.
All right, let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
If you got a brick home right here, and you put double wides all around it, and they, what happens to that brick home?
It depreciates.
If there's double wides throughout that entire county, and they're upkept, and they're clean, and nice
about
yards.
About if the guy has everything he owns in the front yard on several of them, old trucks that don't run, semi-trucks that don't run, and when you come in there, we'll show you the pictures. I'll let you take pictures of that house. Now, explain to me how that makes my house be comparable to a brick home that's 5 miles down the road in a nice area.
Your house is not comparable with that one.
Well, then it's...
But still, your house is a sale or is comparable to houses that have sold. This county here is not zoned. You've got single wides and double wides within sight of almost every house in this county. I mean, they've zoned it now. But you still can't make that mobile home move because he's grandfathered in.
All right, I got one more.
This is not a county that was zoned 50 years ago where you've got all $200,000, all $400,000 houses. This is a very rural county, and it's very mixed as far as what's out there.
If you have a double wide, and that's really a trailer, you agree?
Double wide?
An older one.
It's a trailer.
Not like the ones
that come in on wheels. I try not to call it that because some people
get mad. It comes in on wheels.
Now,
but they pulled the wheels
how
out.
Long, how
yeah,
long?
Still comes in on
how
wheels.
Still move it too.
Well, actually, modular comes in on wheels too, but that's considered a stick built once you see
it. Ain't stick built for
how long does that? How long do you tax that thing?
The double wide, as long as it has value. Some up. If you don't upkeep it, it falls apart in 20 years. It's no good. If you keep it up, put a nice foundation.
How good a shape do you think it is in 35 years?
Depending on the mobile home and how well it was kept up. So you're asking me questions here that are totally general.
You just said it was a double wide. And I just told you it's double wide, and you said a double wide is not a mobile home.
No, I said I prefer not to call it that because people get mad. I didn't say what it was.
I know, but you just did. You just
called it. Well, I consider them that, and I try not to call
them
that. But it's, once again, it's how well you keep it up.
But you won't ever convince me if a big home's sitting here, and you put double wides all around since I've been down here, that the price of everything. And this man came right to my house one time, we talked about that. You remember that? Well, I'll take you back to the house to ask you the same questions I asked you 8 years ago.
I'll be glad to go back, and I'll tell you what I said when you were asking about what's happening in Wilson County. I remember talking to you.
Yeah, I'm sure you do, because you distinctly told me distinctly told me they were moving double wides down there, right down the road from your house.
No, I didn't say right down the road from my house. I said in Wilson County.
And it was hurting the county.
I said in Wilson County, the western edges of the county are starting to split the land up and developing from spillover from Raleigh Durham.
That's right.
And I said, we're losing the farmland, and I don't think that's good for the county.
Well, if it ain't good for the county, how can it be good for this county?
I didn't say it was.
You know?
I'm just saying.
You cannot zone mobile homes out of the county because you have low-income housing. You've got to have it.
If you have a home, you're pretty good with math. You gotta be. If you got a home that's $114,000, and it goes up to $208,000, in 8 years, what is the percentage rate of that increase?
Because those sales show it.
What is the percentage rate? Don't forget them sales. Tell me the percentage rate that you went up. Did you go up 5% a year, 10% a year, 20% a year?
We went up, in your case, 90% over 8 years.
So you're telling me 90%?
If the sales show it, yes, sir.
I'm gonna change it to.
If they show 200%, we go 200%.
Now, my letter's here. From everybody around here, these realtors and all, said she's going 5 to 7%. So where are you getting off jacking us up that much?
Those sales right there.
Is that right?
That's the only thing we're allowed to use.
Okay.
That's what
and let me get this straight now before it's all. You use sales from last year when the economy is good, and you still, even with these letters.
The economy started dropping in 06.
Not like it has now with all sales. I hate to tell you, but you know what?
But this last revaluation was done in 01. In 04 and 05 is when property values really shot up.
Do you ever think about changing the rules?
If they change them, we will gladly change the way we do it. Ad valorem in Raleigh, they make all rules. The Machinery Act is, our law. Everything we do comes out of a book called the Machinery Act.
Are y'all certified or anything to do this?
Absolutely, everyone
else. From where? From where?
Raleigh.
Where Raleigh? I'm asking.
Ad valorem. We have, every one of us is certified through Ad valorem in Raleigh.
You got one of your business cards?
You got a business card?
No, ma'am, because I'm in this county. I've already been in two counties today, and I'll be in a third one before I go to bed tonight.
Does he have a business
card? Can you give him the Ad valorem number?
Well, how do I know where your business is from?
Pearson Appraisal out of Richmond, Virginia.
You're out of Richmond, Virginia?
Pearson Appraisal Service.
You're working out of them?
No, I'm out of North Carolina.
But the same company?
Company that we work for is out of North Carolina.
So do you have one?
Are you a licensed appraiser? Are you licensed appraiser?
I'm a licensed revaluation appraiser. I'm not licensed to do fee appraisals. In order for us to do this work, we all have to be certified and licensed through the state of North Carolina, which we're tested through
Ad valorem. And where does that license come from?
Raleigh.
Where?
Ad valorem. I'll get the number.
Ad valorem tax. They are overseers of all revaluations.
Well, explain something
about
in
Raleigh.
What was that county?
Right down by the Capitol building. I've been to it, but I got certified quite a few years ago. I haven't been back.
Have y'all been to Proclemens?
I did Proclemens myself.
And how did it go over there?
Same way it's going right here.
Nobody liked it.
No, I've never done a revaluation that anybody liked.
Let me get this straight. You're trying to tell me that there's a handful of you people that are way smarter than all the rest of us.
Now you're saying that. I haven't said a word about that.
What was it?
I'm saying we got rules and regulations and we follow those to the letter. If we don't, we're not in business anymore.
Now, I had my hate to sell.
This little meeting we're having here, we have this in every county, but I've never seen a county that didn't do that revaluation. State law, and this is bottom line, says all counties will be revaluated between 4 and 8 years, and this is Gates County's 8th year. Gates County has no choice. Well, it is state law that they do this revaluation. It is state law that it's put at 100% of sales. Now, what you are not mentioning is simply this. After this revaluation, there will be a drop in the tax rate. Your taxes is based on your county budget.
That's 97%, right?
Well, that's what it is now.
97%?
Now, if this county budget is, and I'm making these figures up, if this county budget is $15 million and they have to get 92 cents on the $100 to collect that $15 million, after this revaluation, they take that $15 million budget and they divide it by the new value. If that says, okay, now we need 60 cents or we need 51 cents on the 100, unless the budget is raised, your tax rate will drop, and this county will pay the exact same amount of taxes this year that they did last year, barring an increase, you know, that the county may need.
Let me ask you.
What about the following year?
The same thing. The only way your taxes.